Now we are going to talk about the multiplexer.
Multiplexing is the generic term used to describe the operation of sending one or more analog or digital signals over a common transmission line at different times or speeds. And the device we use to do that it called as a multiplexer. This multiplexer is a combinational logic circuit that designed to switch one of several input lines through to a single common output line by the application of a control signal. For that control signal, we called as a selector. As this multiplexer select one of more inputs, so this multiplexer is called as a data selector. There are shortened names for this multiplexer, and it is MUX, which pronounced as MUX, and the MPX are there. These multiplexers or MUXes can be either digital circuits made from high-speed logic gates used to switch digital or binary data, or they can be analog types using transistors and MOSFETs. So, this is a small representation of multiplexer. There are some input lines and there is a selector. This selector selects one of these inputs and gives it to a single and common output line.
The multiplexers are classified into four types, which are 2-to-1 multiplexer, 4-to-1 multiplexer, 8-to-1 multiplexer and 16-to-1 multiplexer. Let's find out the function of 2-to-1 multiplexer. First, let's represent it. As this name suggests, there are two inputs, I0 and I1, and there is one output. It is called as Y. So let's find the number of selectors in this multiplexer. I take the number of input as n and n is equal to 2. I take the number of selectors as m. So we can represent m as log 2 to n. We can write it again. This is equal to 1. So our number of selectors is equal to 1. So there is one selector. So let's draw the table for this multiplexer. We have one selector and one output. I consider that when the selector is 0, I0 is going to that output. So S is 0 and Y equals to I0. And I consider that when selector is 1, which means S is 1, I1 is going to that output. So S is 1 and Y is equal to I1. So by this table we can get the equation for Y, which is the output. We can get Y equals to, from the first case, S is 0, so S bar and I0. Or from the second case, we can get S is 1, so S and I1. So this is the expression for the output of 2-to-1 multiplexer. We can use this expression to implement this multiplexer in our logic simulator.
So let's demonstrate the 2-to-1 multiplexer using our simulator. So this is the expression that we find out earlier. So let's make the circuit. we can say there are three inputs, I0, I1 and S. Okay, this, let's name it. I name it as I0. And let's reduce the text height. Okay. And we can copy and we can place it here. I name this input as I1. Let's paste again in here. I name is as the selector. I put the selector between those inputs because of the clarity for the circuit. So we can say there are two NAND gates. And another important thing is there are S bar and S. So both S bar and S are here. So there must be an inverter for this S selector. Okay. Now the final gate is an O gate. Let's place it here. Okay, now we have to connect these gates and inputs. For the first AND gate, the S bar and I0 is connected. Let's connect them. And for the second AND gate, S AND S and I1 is connected. In the final OR gate, the results from these NAND gates are connected. So the result of this OR gate will be our output. Okay, let's put some values to these inputs. As we discussed earlier, when the switch is off, when we turn on the I0, the output will be 1. And if we try to give a 1 for I1 besides the I0, let's say nothing happens, because when the selector is 0, only the I0, when only the I0 is 1, the output will be 1. And when the switch is on, let's give 1 to the I1, we can see the output is 1. Then let's try to give 1 to I0 besides of 1, we can see nothing happens. So when the selector is 1, the when only the I1 is 1, the output will be there. So this is how the 2 to 1 multiplexer works. We can select one from several inputs using a selector and give it to a single and common output line. As the second example for the multiplexer, we are taking the 4 to 1 multiplexer. So let's represent it. We can draw the multiplexer like this. This is the 4 to 1 multiplexer. And as this name suggests, There are four inputs. I named it I0, I1, I2 and I3. And there is one output. I called it as Y. And let's find out the number of selectors that we have to put in the multiplexer. So I take the number of inputs as N and N is equal to 4. So I take the number of selectors as M and M is equal to log 2 to N. So I can rewrite this. I can write 4 as 2 to the power 2. So let's rewrite this. This is equals to 1. So M is equals to 2. So there are two selectors. I name these as S0 and S1. So let's draw the table for this circuit. There are two selectors, S1, S0 and Y. I consider that when the both switches are off, which means S0 and S1 equals to 1, the I0 is going to this output. So both selectors are 0 and Y is equal to I01. And when the S1 is 0 and S0 is 1, I consider that I1 is going to the output. So S1 is 0, S0 is 1, so the Y is equal to I1. And when the S1 is 1 and S0 is 0, I2 is going to the output. So S1 is 1, S0 is 0 and Y is equal to I2. And both selectors are 1, I consider that I3 is going to the output. So S1 is 1, S0 is 1 and Y is equal to I3. So let's make the expression for this output. Then we can write Y equals with the first case we can get S1 bar and S0 bar and I0. With the second, the operation in here is O. With the second case we can get S1 bar and S0 and I1. And with the third case we can get S1 and S0 bar and I2. And with the last case we can get S1 and S0 and I3. So this is the expression for the 4 to 1 multiplexer. Let's implement this in our simulator, the SEDA simulator. Let's see how can we do it. So this is the logic circuit for 4 to 1 multiplexer. We can see the truth table here. So when the both switches have 0, so when we turn on give 1 to I1, we can see the output is 1. When the S1 selector is 0, S0 selector is 1, then when we give 1 to the I1, we can see the output is 1. And the next one, S1 is 1 and S0 is 0. S1 is 1. S0 is 0 and then we give input for I2, we can see the output is 1. As the last case, we give 1 to both S1 and S0, then give 1 to I3, we can see the output is 1. This is how the 4 to 1 multiplexer works. It selects 1 from 4 inputs using these two selectors and give it to the single output line. In previous, we talked about the interaction and some examples for the multiplexer. In here, we are going to talk about the application of the multiplexer. The first application is communication system. This communication system is a set of systems that enable communication like transmission systems, relay and tributary station, and communication network. The efficiency of communicating system can be increased considerably using this multiplexer. Multiplexer allow the process of transmitting different types of data such as audio, video at the same time using a single transmission line. That is how the multiplexer is useful in communication system. The next application is computer memory. Multiplexers are used to implement huge amount of memory into the computer, at the same time reduces the number of copper lines required to connect the memory to other parts of the computer circuit. And the next application is telephone network. In telephone network, multiple audio signals are integrated on a single line for transmitting with the help of multiplexers. In this way, multiple audio signals can be isolated and eventually the desired audio signal reaches the intended reception. So these are the some of applications of multiplexer.